Yeah, I have to say that while I'm not, I haven't followed all of this as keenly as some of the deputies, notably Deputy Daly and Deputy Wallace, who've done, I think, frankly, the state great service in how they've pursued the matters surrounding Morris McCabe and whistleblowers generally, and serious problems in the Gard, within the Gardaí, both in terms of how they conduct or fail to conduct proper policing and in how they deal with whistleblowers. My reading of the statement today by Noreen O'Sullivan and the responses of the Minister to the events, if you like, surrounding the O'Higgins report are not satisfactory at all. I don't believe they're satisfactory at all. I mean, to me, there is a glaring contradiction between Commissioner O'Sullivan's statement today to the effect that there was no attempt to impugn the integrity or credibility of Morris McCabe, and the leaked transcript of what the senior counsel for the commissioner, Colin Smith, said to the judge, where he clearly indicated that he got instructions, as Deputy Barry has already said, repeatedly when questioned by Judge O'Higgins, indicated that he had got instructions which were about challenging the credibility and integrity of Morris McCabe. So there is a glaring contradiction there, and that also, I think, raises very serious questions over the commitments and assurances that Commissioner O'Sullivan is giving in the same statement about, if you like, a new regime when it comes to dealing with whistleblowers. I mean, the O'Higgins report, first of all, let's be clear, clearly vindicates Morris McCabe and indicates what a tremendous service he did, if you like, the state, the public, in blowing the whistle on serious failings in the Gardaí in Cavan Monaghan. And O'Higgins, Judge O'Higgins, at least acknowledges, although frankly I think it's an understatement for what Morris McCabe had to be put through, that there was a corporate closing of ranks by the Gardaí in the face of the whistleblowing efforts, if you like, of Morris McCabe. And all of us, I suppose, hoped and imagined that that with the ascension of Commissioner O'Sullivan, with all of the controversy that surrounded the stepping down of the former Commissioner Callanan, former Minister Shatter having to step down, and so on, that we might have, if you like, a new regime that was going to deal with things in a different way. And what instead it appears, what appears to be the case, is that the new commissioner is carrying on precisely in the way that the old regime carried on in dealing with or failing to deal in a proper way with whistleblowers and give them the support and the protection they deserve for highlighting problems, failings, shortcomings within the Gardaí. And I mean, the fact that it would appear the two Gardaí were preparing to perjure themselves by giving evidence to the O'Higgins Tribunal to the effect that Morris McCabe had indicated malice in his allegations against Gardaí in the area, and then were unable to do that because, thankfully, Morris McCabe had recorded the conversation and showed that there was no such malice demonstrated. But the fact that two Gardaí were willing to perjure themselves that the effect of that would have been to undermine and malign, if you like, the incredibility and and integrity of Maurice McCabe, I mean, is incredibly serious. And we hear only now, after all of the furore and complaints and protest about it, that Noreen O'Sullivan is going to refer this to GSOC. But, you know, that doesn't satisfy me at all. It's going to be referred to GSOC. When is GSOC going to report? And has GSOC's record on all of these matters been such that you would have confidence that GSOC is going to get to the bottom of what is an incredibly serious thing? That Gardaí were prepared, it would appear, to tell lies to a judge to malign Maurice McCabe, the person who, as the O'Higgins report clearly indicates, has done such, what does he say, a genuine public service at considerable personal cost, acting out of genuine and legitimate concerns. And the response of this to this is Gardaí planning to perjure themselves and lie about his integrity, but luckily caught out because of the forethought of Maurice McCabe. Now, all of this, you could say, although it isn't, in fact, past history, because there's still a glaring contradiction between what Noreen O'Sullivan is saying in her statement today and what appears to be the case, but all of this, you might say, was in the past, if it weren't for the fact that the same seems to be happening again with other whistleblowers. Now, I haven't had as much contact with whistleblowers as Deputy Daly and Deputy Wallace, but for the first time, I had an extended conversation with one of these whistleblowers earlier this week, Keith Harrison, and had a chat with him just now, again, before coming in here to ask him what he thought about what was being said. And really, it just indicates that nothing has changed. Nothing at all has changed. Because here is another guard who makes very serious... let's just recount the story. Arrested another senior Gardaí for drunk driving. Went to, pursue that, following that arrest, and again was faced by obstacles and resistance by senior Garda management in Donegal, and then started to face bullying, harassment and victimisation by the senior management in the Donegal Gardaí that were supposed to be actually pursuing the person who was arrested and serving justice on a senior Gardaí against whom very other very serious allegations were also being made by Keith Harrison. And Keith Harrison reports to me that when he went to the confidential recipient and a commission of investigation was set up, that information of the affidavits he gave to that investigative team were then leaked to the people against whom he'd made allegations. This is really serious stuff. He goes on to tell me that he has written on four occasions to Noreen O'Sullivan and has received nothing but perfunctory acknowledgements, with no serious follow-through, no protection, no support. He's also, I understand, Minister, written to you in December and has written to you again this week. And similarly, from yourself, only received, from the December letter, a perfunctory acknowledgement, but no real response to the contents of the letter the account he is giving to you of his treatment when he tried to blow the whistle on very serious failings in the Gardaí in Donegal. He tells me that where he's living now, he has Garda cars going up and down on a regular basis at what appears to be a sort of low-level intimidation of him and his family. He has been on sick leave since May 2014. As of this week, he has no income whatsoever. He's had no support from the Gardaí financially or anything else. And now his sick leave, if you like, has run out, and he has no income at all. And he's getting no support from you, Minister, and he's getting no support from Noreen O'Sullivan. So, to my mind, despite everything that has happened, and despite the vindication of Maurice McCabe and the very serious allegations he's made, and indeed the vindication of the two deputies up to my left who have championed these issues and the cause, if you like, of the whistleblowers, nothing seems to be changing. And again, all we get today is another statement that really it just seems to me the Commissioner trying to cover their tracks. Finally we're going to do something now. When the evidence suggests that in fact what they were trying to do right up until recently is still undermine Maurice McCabe, and that we have it on the word of their own legal counsel that that is what they were trying to do. And then you have the treatment of whistleblowers like Keith Harrison and Nikki Kyo. I don't know much about the Nikki Kyo case, but apparently very similar things. So, Minister, you know, it seems to me that Commissioner O'Sullivan simply has no credibility given what has happened. How she treated or attempted to treat Maurice McCabe and undermine his integrity, and similarly in her complete failure to respond to and support and protect whistleblowers like Keith Harrison. And Minister, you know, in all of this, when you know all of this, I don't understand what you are doing and why you're allowing this to stand. I would hope to hear from you that you're not satisfied with what the Commissioner is saying, with the explanations that she is giving. And it would be good indeed to hear an explanation as to what you are going to do to protect whistleblowers like Keith Harrison and others. Because simply, you know, sort of rhetoric about protecting whistleblowers that isn't matched in reality, and that doesn't appear to have matched in reality, and where no change, visible change, seems to be occurring, as we have other Maurice McCabes coming forward, suggests that really, at best, the government is just playing politics with this. And that's indeed what it was doing around the time of the Callan affair, Alan Shatter's stepping down and so on. It's just about playing politics. In fact, the government, a bit like what the senior Gardaí seem to be doing, the Gardaí hierarchy, are just, it's engaged in a closing of ranks. Self-protection. Not serious about really bringing about the reform that we need and following through on its commitments to protect and support whistleblowers. So I don't think any of the serious questions that have been raised around Maurice McCabe or the whistleblowers have been answered, Minister, and I think a very radical change in attitude is necessary for the government if it's to regain any credibility on these matters.
Thank you, Deputy. Deputy Mick Wallace.